I've been getting a lot of notifications and comments from those of you using RGB Fusion or typically any kind of Gigabyte RGB software on an MSI motherboard. Typically, though, I have seen Zoltek and a few others, but I'm here to help you out. I figured it out on my Gigabyte card on my MSI motherboard, and I want to show you how to do it. As you can see here, the Gigabyte Control Center is working perfectly fine. Let me break it real quick, show you how I found it and how I kind of sort of fixed it, at least to make it work. All right, just to show you, Gigabyte Control Center running, starting it up. Everything's working fine. Go into RGB Fusion. You can see the blue lights here. Let's switch them to red, blue, or light blue, purple, orange, and back to the blue I had before. All right, so all good. All right, let me break it real quick. One sec. So now it's broken, like all of you have it now. I'll open the Gigabyte Control Center. Opens for a split second and then just crashes right out. You can't do anything about it. I spent a lot of time looking around the web everywhere. I can't find anything. So what I did was I clicked on the start button. I went into Event Viewer. So I type event up here and I click on Event Viewer. Okay, so I'll click on Windows Logs here, expand it, and then click Application. Okay, we'll notice one error here. Okay, and that error points to the Gigabyte Control Center. So I'm gonna close this out. Let's find out if that was the error. I'm gonna open it again. And now we'll open up the Event Viewer again. I don't leave it running because it'll take longer to show up. And then I go back into the logs and we should see two. There we go, the second. All right, so the Event Viewer shows you all the errors, any application errors or working completely fine. And then with your overall system. So the Event Viewer is awesome to look at. So back to the application and back to the error. The errors aren't always going to be in errors. Sometimes they'll be just in information, but this particular one is in the error section. Okay, so we can see the faulting application. The path is the Gigabyte Control Center, but it shows the gcc.exe, the actual Gigabyte Control Center program. We can't really do anything with an exe. Then we see down here the faulting path, faulting module path, is in the same folder, but it's the SMB controller. The SMB controller is what monitors the temperature, the RGB lighting, and all that stuff. You have to realize that on any machine, typically, there's not only one, there's quite a few. So I have Gigabyte, that has its own. Then I have MSI, that has its own. Then I have the RAM, that has its own. And I have a few others that work on their own. Sometimes they don't play well together. And that's when you get the issue like we have here. So what we do here is I'm going to go ahead and go to where that SMB controller is. So I'll open up File Explorer and I'll type up here and I just copied and pasted it. So I am where the SMB controller is. So now I'll look for smbcontrol.dll. So SMB, and then here we are. So now we can delete the file, but I don't want to ruin it just in case it's needed at some point. So we just rename it. You can rename it whatever strategy you like. You can replace the DLL with old. I like to put a one in the front, maybe one dash. That way I know I played with it. And then sometimes if the application is running, it won't let you rename it because it's using this file. Thankfully in this case, because it crashed, it can't use it. So we can go ahead and rename it. So now it is renamed. I'm going to go ahead and close out of the Event Viewer. And then I'm going to double click on the GCC. It's taking a little bit longer and bam, it's working. How do I confirm it? Well, I come into RGB Fusion and I can change all the colors again and I'll do color shift and wave. That way you don't think I'm using previous video. Everything's working perfectly fine. And then come back over here and we can do updates. And then we can update everything here. And this is why I'm making this video, because I remembered using the updater. The updater renamed that one dash smbcontroller.dll back to smbcontroller.dll, and it broke it, so I had to fix it again. And then it reminded me to make the video for you guys. So just remember, when you use the update center or whatever and it rewrites it, just go back in and fix it and you'll be good. So this will help you with the Gigabyte Control Center and RGB Fusion and maybe a few other things as well. And if it doesn't, just come back and ask me. I reply to all my comments and I always try to help as much as possible. Now, if you want to see this system, how I built it and everything, you can check this video up above. This is Iggy with ThisBytesForYou out. See you guys.